This is a production of PBS 39.
Finally tonight, there's a landmark that rises out of the mountains around the city of Reading. It's called the Pagoda. The seven-story structure, inspired by the ancient buildings of Japan, is as much a part of Reading's history as the last 100 years. For those visiting the city, it's a destination. But for the citizens of Reading and all of Berks County, it's part of a proud tradition, one that the community is honored to celebrate throughout this year. Grover Silcox visited the Pagoda and spoke with community leaders at the first of several centennial celebrations.
In 1908, Americans hopped aboard Henry Ford's Model T as it rolled off the assembly line for the first time. That same year, the Chicago Cubs beat the Detroit Tigers 2-0 in the World Series. William Howard Taft succeeded Woodrow Wilson as president, and popular movie actor Jimmy Stewart was born in Indiana, Pennsylvania. And in Reading, Pennsylvania, folks christened another newcomer, the Pagoda.
The Pagoda is situated right on the top of Mount Penn, and we can see it from all over the city and the county.
William Abbott Whitman, the owner of a quarry atop Mount Penn, built the Pagoda to beautify the mountaintop, which he claimed his operation scarred. Whitman modeled the Pagoda after Japanese Emperor Shogun's palace, which he saw depicted on postcards. He intended his Pagoda to serve as a luxury hotel and restaurant, but it wasn't to be.
It was completed in 1908 for a cost of about $50,000, but he never opened it as a hotel, and so the bank basically took over, and Mr. Jonathan Mould, who was a trustee at the bank at the time, paid off the debt, got the deed to the Pagoda, so he gave the Pagoda as a gift to the city.
That was in 1911, and the city of Reading has owned it ever since. Just recently, the city kicked off its first in a series of centennial celebrations with help from local radio station WEEU. Local musicians, and other community members. Mayor Tom McMahon himself was on hand to join the jubilee.
Today we've had pie eating contests and kite flying contests, and kids are out there doing coloring.
William Whitman's great-grandchildren even showed up for the kickoff event. Cousins Dan Whitman and Marjorie Keene brought the family scrapbook and memories of their great-grandfather.
He used to come to the house where we lived, and he'd bring me coloring books and crayons. I can remember that.
On this day, kids on the Pagoda's second floor do some coloring of their own. They're creating and coloring kites, a popular activity in Japan and consistent with the Pagoda theme. With finished kite in hand, the kids went out on the balcony to launch their creations.
I made a kite, and it says Pagoda on it at the bottom. If it's not really windy, you have to, like, run and get some air on it.
I think it'll touch the clouds.
While some kids sailed their kites in the formidable winds surrounding the seven-story structure, other kids celebrated the cherry blossom season with a little contest presided over by Mayor McMahon.
Oh, there's not much left in this one. What? How much is on your face? Oh, my gosh. So did you like the pie, first of all? Was it good?
First prize winner Alex Lacey wore his cherry pie like a badge of honor.
I basically just put my face into the pie.
Other visitors put their legs into a fun walk from Mount Penn to the city's first energy stadium, home of the Reading Phillies. Still others spent the day planting a temporary garden and generally dressing up the environment in flowers. Inside the Pagoda, tour guide Marcia Goodman Hinterschitz and Mayor McMahon led the way up the structure's 85 steps to the observatory at the top, where a Japanese bell cast in 1739 greets every visitor.
I understand the unique part about this bell is there's no ringer on the inside.
When we strike the bell, we have to realize this is, again, a religious symbol for the Japanese people.
Here in the bell sanctuary, visitors see clear past Reading for 60 miles.
I like when you go up and you can see, like, a lot of places and see when the trees are blooming buds. It looks pretty.
For those on the outside looking up, the Pagoda stands as a beacon. Its lights illuminate the night. On Christmas Eve, Reading's youngsters look for the Pagoda's flashing lights, the traditional signal that they'd better go to bed because Santa is on his way.
This is really our symbol. This is what defines us as a community. And when people are away and that live here and then come back and they see the Pagoda, it gives a real sense of warmth and feeling and saying, well, here we are back again.
The Pagoda began as an idea to adorn a mountain, but it has become much more. For the citizens of Reading and all of Berks County, it serves as a focal point and a gathering place that fosters a spirit of community.
You're not able to put a price tag on something like the Pagoda. It's irreplaceable. It's our legacy. It's what we leave behind. And we ought to be darn proud of it.
For Tempo, I'm Grover Silcox reporting.
Happy anniversary to all the residents of Reading as you celebrate 100 years. That's very exciting.
Support for Tempo is provided by Building a workforce system called PA Career Link Lehigh Valley. Training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs. Connecting employers with workers. And workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
RCN and RCN4, partnering with PBS 39 and committed to bringing quality local television programming to the residents of the Lehigh Valley. RCN, cable, phone, and internet.
And by the members of PBS 39, thank you.